So today I will show you how to customize the sign-in page that NextAuth provides us. So as you can see here, this is what NextAuth provides us for the sign-in page. I will show you how to customize this for it to look something like this. For example, this is the sign-in page, and I'll also be showing you how to add some additional fields to the sessions. So as you can see here, I've added a date and as well as a username here, @pragmaticguy. So this is what I'll be showing you today. So here I've got a project running in the background, and I've got NextAuth installed. If you haven't got it installed in yours yet, what you would do is go to their docs, to the getting started section, copy this line, npm install NextAuth, and install it. After that, what you would do is you would go down, and under the pages directory here, you create a under the pages directory, inside the API directory, you would create a folder called auth, and inside the auth, you would create a file called nextauth.ts. That is what I have here. They are using GitHub provider, I'm using Google as the provider. So from here on, what you would do is first I'll show you. So if I click this, it's redirecting me to this page. This is what NextAuth by default gives us. So in order to customize that, what you would do is go here, pages, sign in, and you give it the path auth sign in. Here also there should be a slash, save it. So I'm getting this basically from here. In the configuration, under configuration pages, if you scroll up, they mention it here. So I'm getting it from there. So after giving it the path, what you would do is inside the pages directory, under the pages directory here, sorry, here, not inside here, again you would create a folder called auth, and inside auth you would create a file called sign in.tsx. okay, after that, for the contents, you would just copy this and paste it here. So now I'm getting a error. This is because of TypeScript. If you're using plain JavaScript, you wouldn't be needing this, but since I'm using it, I'll have to create a type for it. The providers, so providers, the type of this will be return type, type of get providers, yeah. And for the, in this case, we don't need the context. I'll save this, go back here, and I'll click this sign. Yeah, now it's coming up here. As you can see here, they have a button which provider name Google. I've not given anything. It's just taking it from what we have assigned here, nextauth.ts. Here I've said Google provider, that's why it's taken from there. So now if I click sign in with Google, it should give me the profiles, yeah. And if I click one of the profiles, it will redirect me to this page. So this is the sign-in page. This is not what we want. What we would like it to redirect it to the main page. So in order to do that, what you would do is you would go here and inside this in the object callback URL, you press the wherever you want it to redirect it to. So for me it would be the main page. So slash. So let me try again. I'll click it back again. I'll click one of the profiles. Now it should redirect me to the main page. Fingers crossed, come on. Okay, it's working. And it's printing out my name as well. Sign out for now. Okay. So now, okay, it's taking some time. Fine. Click again, sign in, redirects me to this my custom sign in page. So now let me give it some styling. I've already got some styling here. I've already created it before, so I'll just copy this out and I'll paste it here. It's from div, okay. So from here to here. So in order to save us some time, I've already created this. Okay, it's still working. Let's check. Sign in with Google, gives me the profiles. Click one of the profiles, it should redirect me to the home page. It's taking some time. Okay, it's still working. So now I will show you how to have some additional attributes in our sessions. So if I go back to my own custom made sign in page, which is an auth sign in, yeah, here if I console log out a session, so first I'll have to create session data, session use session. If I console log out a session, let's see what is inside. Let me open my dev tools. Okay, so right now in under user I have email image name. So let's say I want date and the username, the at username. So for that, what you would do is you'll go to our next auth.ts file and create the callbacks, backs. So basically I'm getting this from here in the next docs under configuration callbacks. If you go down, you'll find this. I just copied this out. I'll paste this here. So this is because of TypeScript. For now, I'll take any. Yeah, it's gone. And we don't need this. So now to create a date, what you do is session. Inside session, inside user, there will be a date. And for now, I'll keep the date as new, the date, the current date. Yeah, I'll save this, sign in, go to session.user.date. So this error is because of TypeScript. We'll fix that in just a moment. And I'll just check. Okay, it's come here. As you can see, it's come here. Yeah, here. So in order to fix this, again, if you're using plain JavaScript, you don't need this. We'll have to create a file called nextauth.ts, a typings file. And if you go to their docs, one of their docs, yeah, in under TypeScript, they've already given us a boilerplate. You can copy that here. We don't need this, and we don't need this as well. So date. It will be of type string. Yeah. Now it's not giving us any error. If I type dot, yeah, it's giving me date. So we need the other fields also as well, no? Like the name, email, and image. For that, what you do is name is equal to string, image string, and what was the other one? I think it was email. String. Now if you go here, save this, create dot, yeah, I get everything else. I'll also show you how to do the that at username one also. Go here, so create dot user, the user, I'll create username. So at, okay, plus take the session dot user dot name. We'll split that, then we'll join it. This is for not having any space in between, and we'll convert that to lowercase, to local lowercase. and we'll also have to mention it here. Username string. If I save this and I just go username, save it, let's see what happens. See, it's giving me here at pragmatic guy, and if I just print out the session, see, set the object inside the user, I have my date, email, image, name and username. I've got my additional two fields which I wanted. That's all. Thank you for watching. Until next time. So now I will show you how to have some additional attributes in our sessions. So if I go back to my own custom made sign in page, which is in auth sign in, yeah, here if I console log out a session, so first I have to create session data session use session. If I console log out a session, let's see what is inside. Let me open my dev tools. Okay, so right now in under user I have email, image, name. So let's say I want date and the username, the at username. So for that, what you would do is you'll go to our next auth.ts file and create the callbacks, E-A-C-K-S. So basically I'm getting this from here in the next dot docs under configuration callbacks. If you go down, you'll find this. I just copied this out, I'll paste this here. So this is because of TypeScript. For now I'll take any, yeah, it's gone and we don't need this. So now to create a date, what you do is session, inside session, inside user, there will be a date. And for now, I'll keep the date as new, the date, the current date. Yeah, I'll save this, sign in, go to session.user.date. So this error is because of TypeScript. We'll fix that in just a moment. And I'll just check, okay, it's come here. As you can see, it's come here. Yeah, here. So in order to fix this, again, if you're using plain JavaScript, you don't need this. You'll have to create a file called nextauth.t.ts, a typings file. And if you go to their docs, one of their docs, yeah, in under TypeScript, they've already given us a boilerplate. And copy that here. We don't need this, and we don't need this as well. So date will be of type string. Yeah. Now it's not giving us any error. If I type dot, yeah, it's giving me date. So we need the other fields also as well, no? Like the name, email, and image. For that, what you do is name is equal to string. Image string and what was the other one? I think it was email. So string. Now if you go here, save this, create dot, yeah, I get everything else. I'll also show you how to do the that at username one also. Go here, so create dot user. The user, I'll create username. So at okay plus take the session dot user dot name. We'll split that. Then we'll join it. This is for not having any space in between. And we'll convert that to lowercase, to local lower case. And we'll also have to mention it here. Username string. If I save this and I just go username, save it, let's see what happens. See, it's giving me here at pragmatic guy. And if I just print out the session, see, set the object inside the user. I have my date, email, image, name, and username. I've got my additional two fields which I want to. That's all. Thank you for watching.